So let me talk briefly about what we do with the contributions that you pay on behalf of your workers. Part of the contributions collected is used to pay benefits of current retired employees. And to the extent that there is an excess, we invest those monies to generate returns which we will follow to supplement the payment of future benefits. And by the way, just so that you know, the bulk of our investments are domestic, with only less than 5% of our investments offshore. These investments are made with the objectives of long-term growth at a reasonable price and income generation, while we minimize risk and try to optimize returns. Investment of pension funds have to be done very judiciously because there are certain risks you just cannot take. When the time comes for you to pay that pension, you have to have that liquidity, that cash to pay it. There is no sign down when it comes to paying pensions. So the trust invests in broadly three major asset classes. First one being fixed income, which consists of some treasury instruments, fixed deposits with reputable institutions backed with security. We don't do the men's goals. Some repos, bonds, and loan facilities that are extended to creditworthy corporate institutions and the government of Ghana. We invest in some equities, which are basically shares, and some of these shares are listed on the stock exchange, like Echo Bank and all these other institutions that are listed. And then we have some unlisted equities, like our investment in our hotels, for example, a Bali Beach hotel. It's not listed, but we have an equity investment there. And then we have some alternative investments, and these are alternative investments consist of investments such as those we have in real estate, the houses that we build and sell. We have investment in some landed property and projects that we develop. We actually didn't have, we are in a power producing business. We have a power plant, for example, and that helps alleviate loss. We are in a property management business. And then we have some economic, what we call economically targeted investments, the returns of which may not be that good, but you need to do those things to try and stimulate the economy. And we have some other investments in what we call private equity. So as of December 2018, about 96.5% of our total assets under management, which currently stands close to about 9.5 billion Ghana cedis, were performing quite well. And this management is working hard to improve and also ensure that we can achieve better yields on these investments. And for the few that are not performing as it should, management is working very hard to try and salvage and get them to be performing as well. The trust non-performing portfolio, non-performing loans for 2018 constituted only about 3.2% of the total corporate loan portfolio. And I must say this compares quite favorably with the average non-performing assets of banks in 2018, which stood at about 18.2%. These funds, which the trust has invested in the economy, has one, boosted job creation and stimulated economic growth, enhanced the provision of energy and power to sustain economic productivity. I just told you about a power plant that we own and operate. It's also contributed immensely to the development of Ghana's capital markets. We have a lot of investments on the stock exchange. It's playing a key role in some financial institutions being able to meet their minimum capital requirement when the governor of the Bank of Ghana said that everybody has to now, all banks have to have at least 400 million Ghana cedis. Some banks rely on us to be able to give them that support to be able to meet that minimum capital requirement. It's also increased access to tertiary education through our student loan program, which we eventually seeded off to the student loan trust fund. And by extension, has helped develop the human capital of this country. Last but not the least, we've helped in some way to reduce the housing deficit and provided office accommodation for several corporate institutions.